Hello everyone, and today we're looking at episode 5 of Surviving Minecraft. And currently it is nearing the late afternoon in the game here, and what we're going to do is wait for nightfall. Ooh, take some damage. Wait for nightfall, and then we're going to go mob killing. Specifically, we're looking for skeletons, because we need some bones to make our wheat grow, so that we can harvest our wheat faster, so we can make more cows quicker. Because currently, all we have are baby cows. Because I am in the middle of making the basic enchantment room. Let me go show you guys what it's going to look like. I've already basically mocked up the actual room itself. It's pretty simple, straightforward at this point. This first go at it is not going to have any customizing of the levels. It's just going to be all or nothing. So you'll have the option of doing level 30 every time. And you can see that I'm trying to incorporate, you know, significant points of my island in the different buildings that I'm going to make. And this enchanting room is no different. Let me see if I can repair that. That looks weird. Okay. So, I came across this little clearing with a tree the other day, and I thought to myself, man, it'd be really cool if I could just incorporate that tree into some kind of room. So I just kind of built into it and around it. Put a little roof on it. And voila. Right
the enchanting here table
is going to be the, and then bookshelves are going to be too high, and then all the way around the perimeter here. With the, so this is 14, if you go right here, with the 15th one being right there, so that I get the maximum levels. Pretty simple, pretty simplistic, but I think it'll be really cool. And then once we go to the Nether, I'm going to put a glowstone block there. I was doing some mock-ups in my creative world, and it looks pretty sweet if we do it like that. So, let's just do some mob killing. I did some caving off camera in between the episodes down in this cave here. It's a pretty extensive system of caves, but I'll be able to finish all that up. Let me see if I can get this. Where do I want to hide? I'm going to kill this Enderman. There we go. I need to be able to hide. Come on, dude. Come on. What's your deal? Are you scared of me? Because you definitely should be. Great, now he's not going to be able to find me. Oh, this is annoying. Well, what do you do here? There we go. Okay, where'd he go? Oh, look at all the creepers that just spawned. Great, now he's gonna spawn and kill me. Not if I'm in water. So, that is essentially this episode. We're gonna make an enchanting room. And once we get that done, we can finally start finishing out the rest of the mine. The basic grid mine that I'm doing. And then once we get the mine done, things cool. Like, we can go to the Nether, find the, what's it called, stronghold. Go to the end, fight the dragon. Set up a Enderman farm. I know that there is a mine shaft. I found a mine shaft in the grid that I want to go to pretty soon, so we can set up a cave spider spawner system. So that'll be fun. Yeah, I did one of those. I think I did one of those in my last Let's Play. Let's see if I can get this skeleton. Yes, a record. Now we're going to have a jukebox. And no bones. That's okay. We got a record. That was unexpected. So, I've been doing some thinking as far as what to do with this world and this this island. And I know that you can make beacons from the Nether stars that the what do you call them? The Wither ghosts drop, and that they give you, you know, certain buffs if you're in a certain range of the beacon. And so I think what I want to do is every, you know, building I make around the island, I want to have, I don't know how big the range is on those beacons, but I want each of them to have their own beacon, or at least different sections of the island, so that each section of the island has different buffs associated with it. And along with that, I want to do some simple settlement type things where I make like a lighthouse. That'd be pretty cool. And a really cool boat dock. And I'm going to hold off on really customizing and getting into my main home for a while, because I want to really put some good thought into it and do it upright. And, you know, typically in the past, what I've done is make a home under the surface, so like in caves and in the rock. I don't want to do that in this world. I want to have an actual home. So I'm going to put some more thought into it and probably do it the way that, you know, I hate to keep referencing Doc, but do it the way that Doc does it in his new Let's Play where he, oh crap, where he did all of his farming and resource, resource management at the beginning of his Let's Play, or his world tour. That way, when he finally gets into building his main base, he's got all of those resources taken care of. Okay, let me go fix this hole in the ground we just made. I have no idea what this looked like before. I could check the video, I guess. But we'll just make it look something close to what it was. Do-do-do-do. That's pretty close. And that's going to get annoying real quick. Ooh, so is that. Can't have that. Oh, there's that guy. Another Enderman. Let's go kill him. What? sound is really annoying. Where did he go? Oh, come on. Is he way over there? Got our bones. Another bone. What a fool this guy is. Oh, I didn't even get a pearl for it. Come on. Oh, well. Well, we ended up with 3 bones. That was kind of weak. But such is life. Okay. Oh, my gosh. My sword's almost gone. Just clean up here. And burning zombies. One more. Come on. There we go. Yes. 5 bones. There we go. That's better. Ooh, an enchanted bow. 6 bones. Much better. Should give us, I think, 18 of the stuff. Wheat. No, bone meal. Okay, now I've got... I thought I had some dirt. Oh, I put it back. Well, I'll have to fix that later. Hi, you're friendly. Okay, let me go back and avoid the creeper. And I will make some wheat, and I'll see you in a second. Okay. Got the wheat, but I hear another skeleton. Great. Come on. Oh my gosh. Those things are annoying when they're... Oh, took some shots in the head. That's funny. Oh, I can't even feed the cows yet. Dang it. Okay, well, I'll bring you guys back whenever I can feed them. Tell you what, tree farms make it feel like I'm cheating. But they sure are productive. And massive breeding. Everybody breed. Everybody breed. Oh, one poor lonely fifth wheel. Tough luck, dude. Tough luck. Carry on. Okay, so let's go do some caving. This looks like a good fun good place to start. And then, how do we get down? Does it work? Okay, so if you guys don't know, my trick to caving, lighting up caves, is just to, sorry guys, that was a huge lag spike. Anyways, my trick to caving is I'll just run through and, I don't want to use that, I will, what do you call it, place torches on the right hand side as I'm going into the cave, and when I want to leave the cave, I just make sure to keep the torches on my left hand side. It's a basic breadcrumb strategy, but it works rather well. And as I am, oh boy. There's a guy. I see him. My main goal here is to eliminate, to light up the area, get the resources, eliminate mob spawning as much as I can. And kind of get that under control. You know, so I will be gathering up the coal right here, for instance. And this is going to be something that's going to make my life much better once I can enchant some tools, get it out of the Iron Age, as it were, and use mostly diamond tools for my digging. It's going to make things go a lot faster. But like I was saying earlier, I'm going to hold off on really finishing up my main base area until I get a better handle on what I want to do with it, how I can incorporate the natural play of this island that I'm on into my designs, and so on and so forth. Since I'm on a island with mostly the spruce trees, I'm going to make most of the structures out of wood. And let's see how I can make them. I'm sure there's a lot of cool ideas I can come up with to get different designs and stuff together with wood. Okay, grab that, put that up. Okay. There we go. And pressing on. So, alright, once I go through and light these caves up, I'll come back and really gather up the resources here. You can see all this iron down at the bottom. Lots of good stuff here. Oh, boy. Come here, you. Come here. There we go. And really, whenever I'm doing this, I'm trying to put almost more torches than I think I need. Because I mean, I might as well. I'm already down here. I don't want to come back here too many times if I don't have to. So, anyways, I'm going to light up. I'll keep you guys here for a little bit longer. But we're going to try and light up most of this stuff while we're waiting on the cows to grow up. And the goal for the end of the episode is to have a full working enchantment room. I did some math. It's going to take... I've already got all the paper that I need for the books. I'm just trying to get the leather. And it's going to take... Let me refer to my notes real quick. It's going to take 144 pieces of paper, 46 leather, and 90 planks of wood to make all of the bookshelves. And let's also tack on the 4 blocks of obsidian and the 2 diamond to make the enchantment table. So I think I've got everything except for the leather right now. Oh my gosh. Gotta go way down there. Yeah, so we're pretty close. We just need to get the rest of the leather together. And I apologize if I'm quiet. I'm kind of trying to concentrate right now so I don't fall. Tell you what, these bats are really annoying sometimes. Is this a ravine? I mean, it doesn't really look like a ravine unless it's the tail end of one. Okay. Let me get back up in there and light that up. And I'll update you guys once I have something more interesting. See you soon. Okay, so this is exciting. Found an abandoned mine shaft, and I'm sure that there are some spiders around here somewhere, some cave spiders. I mean, you can hear them. So, this is the dangerous part of caving. Ooh, there's some lava. I think they're right above me somewhere. Oof. Creepy little guys. That's okay. We'll find the spawners, deactivate them, and then set up a farm or something out of them. I think I'm at the very bottom of, ooh, there's some redstone, of that mine shaft. So let's see what I can find. Creepers. Mushrooms. I'll have to grab that for sure. Another thing of redstone. Thinking that the skeletons are right on top of me. I think they can come through the walls is what the deal is. It's always tricky trying to negotiate. Especially whenever it's everywhere. I should have brought a bucket of water. I have an empty bucket, but it has no water in it. Well, I guess I can do the old-fashioned way. So far, so good. Wow. You guys just missed out on something amazing. Creeper just scared the crap out of me and nearly killed me. Whew. Oh, that would have been bad. I'm way down in this cave. Having all sorts of lag issues tonight. Man, that would have been bad. You know, it's that moment whenever you hear the and you're like, oh crap, I can't do anything about it. We've all been there. Okay, let me recover real quick. Okay, I'm good. Okay, guys, here we go. Oh, gosh. Get out of here. Get out of here. Whew. Wasn't prepared. I just thought I was prepared. Oh, jeez. I wonder if I can hit him. Yes. 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 Where is this guy? Oh, there it is. Dang it, they always get the jump on you. On. Whew. Gotta stay healthy. Yeah, it's right around the corner there. Okay, we're going to do something smart. We're going to tunnel into it. We will not be beaten by a mere cave spider spawner. Can I get through a one gap? I can't remember. I'll be killing them quickly. Come on. Okay. Let us do this. Let us tunnel up above them. We can drop some lava on them. Gotta make sure to keep this thing lit up. Oh crap. They can get through the one gap. Don't know if you knew that. Oh my gosh. Stupid poison. Okay. Oh, this is exhilarating. Look at them all. Oh my gosh. Okay, they should be dying now. Yeah, that's the sound we want to hear. Another one? Come on. I need to find the spawner so I can take it out. Think it's right here. Oh, no. Of course it's not. There's a wall right there. Okay, so let's go ahead and bust through right here, I think. Yeah. There it is. Awesome. Oh boy, oh boy. Oh, that was close. All these spider webs. Go ahead and light this beast up. The whole thing's just burning now. Okay, I feel pretty safe in saying that this is now a disabled spider spawner. Okay. Well done, everyone. A couple more just for safekeeping. Now, we gotta go back here and fix what we've done here. Well, I think the cows are probably good to go by now. So I'm going to clean this up and I'll meet you guys on the surface.
Mm-hmm.
So now we have our bookshelves. The only thing left to do is turn the sound down. There we go. Much better. The only thing left to do is create... need more obsidian. The enchantment table. Okay, let's try this again. Book. Diamond. Enchantment table. Okay, onward. Oh wait, we gotta get the... I'm only level 9. I was gonna say we gotta get our diamond pickaxe to enchant it. I used to be at level 34. Then I died. A couple times. So now I'm back down to a level 9. But I can put a level 9 enchantment on my iron pickaxe, I guess. That'll be cool. So, let's hurry over there as slowly as we can because we keep getting stuck on the terrain. It's just the hardest thing to do. Oh, there we go. Oh man, this is looking good. Okay. Now, bookshelf, 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 bookshelf. And bookshelf. One more for good luck. Enchantment table. Yes. Here we go. Is everybody ready? Level 9. What's it going to be? Here we go. Oh, unbreaking one. That's terrible. Oh, man. Well, you win some, you lose some. I think it'll be okay. It'll work. It'll help with our digging, which will help get us to level 30. We can enchant the diamond pickaxe. Be much better off. I did some caving down here. Okay. Let me go check the recording and see how long this episode is getting. I don't want to end it on a short note like that. So, let me go check that real quick. Well, everyone, I have done it. I've completed digging out all four directions of the mine. Took a lot of work, but it was well worth it. Got a loading error over there. Looks like the sun is going down. How cool. Yep. So you can see all four directions. I have dug out 100 blocks. Now the next step of the mine is going to be connecting the corners. So I'll dig, you know, 50 blocks that way, 50 blocks that way for all four sides and connect all of the corners. So far, I've collected quite a bit of resources just from down in this mine. And this is just from digging the four main arteries. I have not even begun actually branch mining at all on this. I've gone through a few iron picks. As soon as I get back up to level 30, though, we're going to be enchanting a diamond pickaxe, hoping for a good one. At this point in the game, a good digging pickaxe would be very good. Something like, efficiency 3 or efficiency 4, unbreaking 5, something like that. That would be really cool. Really cool to have right now. So, next thing that I'm going to do is kind of go through... clean up any of these resources that are just right on the edges. Make sure I've sealed off any holes from any caves I opened up because I don't want to get surprised by bad guys. And we'll see how much experience doing all of that gives me.
There's a zombie. Get out of here. There we go.
As you can see, this is still an unsafe place. No worries. We'll make it better.
Ouch. Well, that hurt. Okay, guys. It is time for a enchantment. We have ourselves one diamond pickaxe, 27 levels, and let's see if we can't pick up a good one. I might have to block off one or so of the bookshelves. Let's see if that did the trick. 28. Dang it. One more. Okay. Let's see if that did the trick. 26. Looks like it's only going to be 26. Okay. Here we go. There we go. A good digging pick. That's not bad. Not bad for the first one. Unbreaking 3, efficiency 3. Should do fine. Okay, guys. Well, I think this is going to do it for this episode. There's not much left that I wanted to do in this one. Pretty soon we're going to have to start setting up a rudimentary slime farm and dig out some more of the mine. We're going to have to set up another portal, the first one in this world. Oh my gosh. I still have some caving to do, apparently. Get rid of these mobs. Let me see. I wanted to show you guys one thing before I called it quits. And it's almost nighttime again. Actually, I want to show you guys two things. Okay. Over there is my mining facility. Past that is my current little hidey hole base thing. But I've been doing some terraforming right over here. Flatten out this piece. I think I'm going to make my right here. It's got a good view of the water, good view of the island. I think it'll be great. So that's where I'm going to put my house, I think. I'm going to try and make it mostly out of these spruce wood. I want to try and use the resources that are available to me and not resources that are foreign to this island. And then right here, I'm going to make the nether portal. Figured it'd be cool going into the wall. So it'll turn this area into the nether area. And I'm not sure what I'm going to do with this area yet. I have to turn it into something else. I don't really like this storage room. It's kind of bland. So we'll have to come up with something different. But anyways, let's go have a quick sleep. And thanks for watching, guys.